ス。
Hello, everyone. I'm Robert Simmer. Welcome to a special, special video. This is a Let's Build a House collaboration. And it's with Simmer Tom, I think it. Oh, no, it's Speed Builds. Sims 3 Speed Builds, sorry. I get his Twitter name and his YouTube name mixed up. So here's the house that he made me build. You saw it a little bit ago. It's already going too fast. I have compressed 6 hours, 16 minutes, and 35 seconds of video down to 1 hour and 6 minutes and 15 seconds. Now, I could not make it shorter because there's just too much footage. And once I did make like the footage go faster, it started to get dodgy that you couldn't see things as well. It's bad enough right now, so we're just going to work with this. If you guys just want to put me on background, you can, and just check in every once in a while. But, yeah, I'm going to sit here and talk for an hour for you guys. So, this is... Oh my gosh, the ground's unlevel. Okay? The ground's unlevel. So... Here I am building the house. I'm trying to get... Because I didn't flatten the lot... I'm trying to get the house to be flat on the lot, and, here I am putting the roof back to the way it was. He wasn't able to upload this to the exchange for me, so I had to rebuild it myself, which is totally fine with me. I don't really care. It was challenging to kind of recreate, because he just sent me pictures, no, like, blueprints, but that's what I told him to give me, because I felt like I could, I felt like I could recreate it just by pictures. So here I am making the garage. It is split-level garage because of there being a foundation, so I had to make the garage work in that essence that it's going to be a split level right there. Now, the house looks completely different after we're all done, but this is just how it starts out, which I think is really, really amazing to me, how everything can change like that really fast, make something look completely different. I'm tinkering around with the new stilted foundation. I didn't know if I wanted to put like a stilted foundation there or not, but, you know, I didn't. Here's like a side door into the garage, which we've already passed, and yeah. So this is where the living room's gonna be. I'm building where the living room is actually gonna be taking place right now. It is like a turret. If you know what a turret, it's a turret, not a turret. What am I trying to say? A turret, I said it again. Turret, whatever. how they're round, and I know it's still flat, flat walls, but we don't have any curved walls in The Sims 3, so we have to create our own, and so that's it right there. I just to warn you guys, I had forgotten to press the record button quite a few times while recording all this footage, so... this house is probably over 6 hours, maybe even close to 7 hours working on it. I've worked on this house for a few, maybe a week. Probably about a week now. So that's pretty much the complete shape. There is added parts like this that I add on that make it look more interesting. Which, it does make it look interesting a lot. And taking some of that off so I can make it a split-level deck. I was checking what the stairs looked like, because these were new stairs that came with the newest expansion pack that I got. And I just wanted to check them, because I didn't want, any different design on them and anything like that. Here we go, adding in like a half wall, and now we're recreating the top part so that we have a little bit more deck room up there. Ooh, it's so dodgy. Oh my god. Okay, so we're gonna be creating the front deck right now that you get on, you walk up on to get into the house. Yeah, here we go, building it. We're building it. Yeah, it's just a square. I don't like how I made it like that, but it's just a square. That's actually where the kitchen's gonna be. That sunken in part right there. Yeah, that's where the kitchen's gonna be. It's gonna be a little bit bigger than that once we get back to it, but it's gonna be a sunken kitchen right there. I had some problem. I wanted to put the wall right there, but for some reason it wouldn't let me put the wall there. So I tried to fiddle around with it and stuff, and it still would not let me put the wall there. I think it was because of it being warped, I wasn't able to put it there, so I just made it like that, but that's not how it ends up being. I end up changing it back to its original. And there's one of the me not recording the part, so that's the finished of the front. Here I am adding another like little deck area that I don't think I made it an actual deck. I think I just made it a piece of just decoration. So there I am flattening off the roof. Now this was really hard. This really ticked me off a lot. It kept giving me problems. It kept warping the upstairs, and it kept like you'll see in a little bit, I think, right there. You see how it goes into the door? It kept doing that, and I kept getting really mad at it. So I still kept the idea going. I ended up doing that, and I got it. I finally got it, but then I decided to move it over, and it really ticked me off. But then I thought, oh well, that wasn't that hard, and that's it, finished. I was measuring the backyard because I didn't want a very small backyard. I wanted a nice size backyard. So right now I'm just trying to figure out what I should do for the back because it looked very bland. There goes the split leveling of the living room, and there goes me putting in a patio door right there. Yeah. And there I am putting you know how I did the front part of the deck? I'm gonna be putting more of those right here. Just for decoration, I don't think I made it be able to be used or anything. Because I like those little jetted out parts like that. I think it's really cool. Oh, and here's where I decided to make the top of that one level lower. In fact, let me tell you this. In The Sims 3, you can only have 5 floors, and this house is a 5-floor house, but yet it only has 2 livable floors. So, I mean, like the basement, like the foundation and the split leveled middle part right there, it doesn't, you can't use it, so it considers it as one of the levels, but yet you can't use it. So it's really two levels, but it says it's 5. Here we go. I'm making the laundry room actually right here. Yeah, I just made it. I'm not putting anything in yet. I did all of the building first. Well, except for the upstairs when I started laying down the floor plan for the bedrooms and stuff. There's another one of those parts where it just comes out just because I wanted it to be decorative. And there goes my door in again. The back and the front, Was really happy with the back, but I mean the front, but I did not like the back at all at first. I was having a really hard time figuring out what I should have done. Oh, those are little balconies that I don't even use. No doors go out to it. So if you download this, you would be able to change that if you want. But yeah, onto that, you will be able to download this. I'll put a link in the description. Here I am putting some color. I'm trying to pick a color. That was terrible. I don't know why I picked that, but I think I might have picked it because of the this is like a Mexican type vibe of a town, so I thought that looked Mexican. It does. But you know, I was trying to put texture into this house, but it just did not look right. I don't know what was wrong. But yeah, so I went through a couple. This is just the first color too. This is for like those stilted areas. And I thought about using the wood because I thought the wood would look good, but it didn't look good at the end. I mean, like, I could have probably used it as something else. I didn't have to put it on that. Like, I should have used it for one whole other part, but you know what? I'll probably do that in the next house I build. But yeah, I go through a couple revisions 'cause I didn't like a lot of the things I did. And then I added the wall back there that I had taken away, thinking that would look cool, but I didn't think it looked cool at all. So I'm going through and making another color choice again. I went for this aqua blue, and I don't keep it 'cause it does not look good outside. It looks good on furniture. It does not look good outside. I think that's the color I actually choose, but in the l after a while, I change it to like to a blue. Oh, and I was trying to do another brick thing again, but I think it was the brown that threw me off. Like, that's a beautiful brick. If I would have made it a different color, it would probably look better. Here we go, putting this color. I was tired of trying to figure out that color, so I just wanted to put it down because it's like a white color, so it doesn't really matter. You could change it whenever. But like, the base coat of the house wasn't even on yet, so you know, I wanted to put the base coat on and then figure out what I wanted to make it from there. And there I go, putting more on. I'm changing the colors as I go. This brown color I thought was what I was gonna go with, but I ended up going more colorful considering. Oh, here comes the color I actually do use. Here it comes. I was like, where was it? Where was it that I put the color on? 'Cause you see the houses in the background? They're so colorful, and that's what the town is. It's a colorful paradise type look. So I wanted to make it colorful, and I did. So I made it's called Tropical Blue, in case I did not tell you that. And it's a tropical house, and it has a whole bunch of blue colors on it. So if you're not a fan of blue, you could always change it to a different color, but please do not re-upload it. You see that warped part right there? I just put the color on it. Not where I am right now with the green. That's gonna go too. That was disgusting. I don't know why I even put it on there at first. That warped part, you cannot put any texture on it because it does not look good. So you have to put a solid color like the green and the blue that I have. And if you don't do that, then it doesn't look good. But I did not put anything that wasn't a solid color on that warped part. But yeah, that green was horrible. I don't know what I was thinking. Like, that stayed on for pretty much 4 days out of my whole entire, you know, color. I mean, my whole entire thing. I had just changed it yesterday. I'm so glad I did. I'm not gonna tell you the color I changed it to because I honestly don't really remember. But trust me, it looks a whole lot better. And did I color that? I hope I colored that. I just noticed that I might have not colored underneath that one porch. That one porch had no color. underneath of it, because I always looked at it like that. I didn't look at it underneath. But I think I might notice it in a few minutes. I'll probably go down floors and then find it that it's not colored. Here I am making another little really cool patio deck area. This, I don't know why I put it there really, 'cause I don't put anything out on that part that I'm working on right now. I do put something on the part that it's connecting to, but I don't put anything on the part that I'm working on. Which is really sad, 'cause it's really cool looking. I shouldn't have made that whole row though, a blue color though. Oh, here we go. This is my favorite part of the house. This is the pinstriping I put on the side. I think it's so awesome, and it brings a lot of texture into the actual full-out design. Here I am putting columns in. These stay like really well. Well, they work really well, and they stay. It's the blue color, and they pop out at the top in case you can't see. They pop out at the top, and I just thought that looked cool, so I kept it. Here I go putting doors and windows in because I felt like I was done with the colors. I didn't think I needed to change them. I was so wrong though. I think that's the garage I used. That's definitely the door I used. That door is from Showtime, and then I don't use that window because that window didn't overlap the way I wanted it to. These windows do though. So those windows are for the base game, so you'll see them popping up everywhere. I used quite a few windows. I never do a window variation, but I did it this time and I thought it was really cool. So, you should, if any of you are simmers, you should really try that because it's really cool. Like, what I tried to do, I didn't really like it as much. Those are awesome from the base game. And there I go. I tried to cover up that green color. I didn't really like that. I think I was starting to not like it there at first. Putting the floor in the laundry room, that's not the permanent floor, that's just the floor I put in. These windows, right, that window right there, and those windows I just put in, they are from University Life. And I think they're really cool windows. Here, I'm just putting more windows in. The windows on top of the garage door, the door that comes out of the garage, never went back. I don't know why. So I might go in and change that again, but I don't know if I will. The only way to get upstairs is through an elevator, and there's a really interesting way I did this. Because this is a split level, you're not usually able to use a elevator, and I thought that this elevator shaft worked as if you were to put it in like the floor there, but it doesn't. So I had right after I did that, right after I finished this part at least, I went in, I put a sim in this town, and I tried it out, and it didn't work. So then, because I had my sim own the property at that time, while my sim owned the property, I went into build by mode and I played around with it, and it worked. So I was happy about that. So right here, I'm changing the color of the half walls, the rail part, because I wanted it to match the wall color, and I think that really looked really nice. So yeah, that's that. And I'm flattening the roof back down. And I'm putting those in there. I almost forgot to put those in there. Putting a door in. I had to do a lot of cheats to make this house. Move objects on, testing cheats enabled by debug. Constraint floor elevation was a big one. That's where the dining and the kitchen are gonna be. Here I am changing the rooftop color because I think that's a very important part of your entire house is the roof color and the deck colors. So I changed those colors and everything. Here I go decorating the top. I actually went through a couple revisions off camera with this because I didn't know. I like everything that you see laid out stayed, but the colors were changed throughout. And you'll see what the end result is because it'll just pop right up right there. That's the end result. There I go, changing the door. Moving the door. It didn't center well, so I didn't, keep the door there. Here I am adding more windows to the living room. Changing the color of the, did I change the upstairs? Oh, I really hope so. Oh my gosh, I will be PO'd if I did not do that. I love to have my elevator colors match because it's just right? Here I am putting the steps into the kitchen. I think that's the actual size of the end product of the kitchen. I'm working on the garage a little bit more now. There goes in a bathroom right there. Here I go putting steps in for the constraint floor elevation, putting steps in for the laundry room. Sorry, laundry room. Cannot think. Oh, and the pillars. They're actually like still. They're not stilts. They're columns which help hold stuff up in midair, and so I just flattened down the squares that would help you hold the stuff up. Now what I'm doing here, you see all that black part, and I'm going through and looking and seeing where the black part is and filling it in. I just like doing that because it makes it feel like it's an actual house, because the black part is the parts that you cannot go in, and it also tells all the players that play the game and download the house that your Sims can't play that, go on there. I'm picking a driveway color and a walkway color. This is the end colors because those are usually the ones I kind of always use, which is not a bad thing, I don't think, but they're really nice. So yeah. Excuse me. Man, I really feel like I did. I'm having second guesses on what I did with this house. I don't think I put a different color flooring on that top deck in the front and stuff like that. Here I'm building a modern gazebo, with the stilted foundation. I did find something to do with the stilted foundation, so I was kind of happy about that. But the outside deck upstairs has carpeting. I don't think I changed it to anything else. I hope I did. I really do, because that carpet is not nice at all. It's just like dots. If I didn't change it and I go and look in the pictures and I didn't change it, I'll go change it in the house, because that's a big no-no. That's a complete big no-no. You need to have everything completely finished before you upload everything. So, and plus, I'm not uploading it yet because Well, when I'm recording this, I'm not going to upload it yet because Sims 3 Speed Builds has had a few problems with his computer and is not able to do the competition right now. But words, Bobby, words. His computer crashed and everything, so he had to reset his computer and put all of his games back in. So I think he might be building right now, but If he isn't, that's fine, but we're hoping to get done soon. Like, whenever he's able to, we're gonna put everything up. Here I go, working on the garage. That is not the final car that I put in. This is a really cool thing. I put a boat. I looked at all the boats because I haven't been able to look at all of them. And I put that boat, and I changed the boat, get this, to the color of the house. Some people would think that would be weird, but I don't think that's weird. Here I go. I went into the fast lane stuff pack and brought some of the garage tool stuff and everything like that. I had to turn the constrained floor elevation false off to put the stairs in. I had the hardest time figuring out why that wouldn't work, but then I realized after a while that you had to take away the oh yeah, I couldn't put a half wall there. I forgot about that. That I had to take away the sides of the stairs to put that to put walls there. Man, I'm starting to get that kick where, oh, I can't talk anymore. I'm sorry, if I'm boring you. I'm trying to be as interesting as possible. It's really hard to be interesting on YouTube, especially when you are creating videos. I should have put something in that corner. I should have put like a workbench or something. So that wasn't empty, but whatever. Too late now. I did change it. Good. Because I did not. The outside, the walkway to the door, I did change the floor because the floor used to be what's inside the house right now. And I'm glad I changed it because I did not like that. And I was hoping that I didn't, put that on there. I did put black behind that. I don't know why. I'm just weird that way. I didn't write it right or something. I don't know. Oh, there. I was like, it should be like gone, but I guess not. I had to turn that on and off a lot because if I didn't, everything would get messed up. So, I tried to keep everything from not getting messed up and me having to fix everything. Here we go. I'm creating the laundry room right now, which is kind of odd to me. I didn't know what to make. Oh, I changed the mailbox. I didn't know what to make this little room here. I was gonna make it a little work area, but then I was like, no, this should be the laundry room because I haven't built a laundry room or used laundry in any of my houses for the longest time, and I'm gonna start using it a little bit more. But I just put it in here thinking that would be good, and yeah. So, yeah. My phone's ringing. I can't pick it up though. Hold on. Chris, go pick up the phone! Sorry. I'm not recording this twice. I'm not recording this twice. And I'm just putting some stuff in here just to look and see what it is. Oh god, my phone's off. Good. Phew. My cell phone better not ring or else I won't pick it up. Do you know who it was? Oh, nobody we know. Never mind. sorry about that. I'm not supposed to do that while I'm recording. I'm sorry. So here we go, making the bathroom. I know it's in a weird place. It's in the garage. I know that's weird, but in that you have to walk out into the garage. But this is like the only place I could put it. Now I could have moved the door, I guess, but I felt like that was the best setup that you could use. So yeah. Did I change the upstairs flooring? I guess I did. What was this? Oh, here I finally went out and brought my Sim back, and this is me messing with the elevator because I tried it and she couldn't go up, And now I'm trying to make the elevator work. And it's actually quite cool how I got it to work. Right there, when you do that, it makes like a diamond shape. And it's fine. You can see a little bit of the color of the wall peeking out of the. I did change that too. Peeking out of the elevator door, but it doesn't matter to me. As long as it works, it's fine. And it does work. I did check it. It does work. I made her go up the stairs as well, so the stairs work as well. Everything right there works. So if you were to download it, it would work. Here we go, adding the steps to get down to the living room. Sorry, I couldn't think of where this was. The living room. Right behind those steps is the dining room, and then I'm gonna work on the kitchen right now. So the kitchen. Okay, so this was the thing. I had recreated this kitchen 2 times. This is the second time, and the first time it was blue, and I found out that I was putting too much blue in the house, so I made this a corally pink color. A corally pink color kitchen, and the countertops were corally pink, and I like that green. But that's the end color. I put a little island in the middle. Oh, I also used disable snapping two slots on alt. I put the cabinets up higher on the floor above it. I just thought that would be the best idea to do. And I put those in just to make it lower. Why not use that upper space instead of having a giant opening at the top? That was my thought. And I was trying to look and see what the countertop would look like as a marble, but it didn't work. And then I put pots and pans over top of the island in case you didn't see. All the appliances are white and the sink is black. I don't think I picked that right. And I really hope that that sink is not custom content, this one. Oh no, I did make it white. Okay. I really hope I did not make that sink custom content. I made all the appliances white as well. All the smaller appliances white or a sort of silver color. Here I go putting in some rugs. I just put them in there just and waited. And now I'm gonna go change the color of the rug right now, and there it is. I needed to cut some footage out, and I thought maybe cutting some of the rug coloring would be good, so I cut some of it out. So I think that's actually the color of the walls. You see those black square like yellow things? Those are like cheat lights. What they do is they light up the room without actually having to have lights in the room. So I have them there because this house gets really dark at night, and trust me, I found that out afterwards, and I was like, thank God I put them in. Here I am putting the dining table in. I also had to do this twice, but I did the same colors pretty much. With all the dining, with everything in the dining room. So this table is two tables fit to be one, and I think you can sit 12 Sims at it, which is really, 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 really nice, especially for parties. I made this room blue because that was not going to change. That was the actual color of the old room, and it was blue. I should have left the floor a little bit darker, but I like what I did with it. I'm adding the rug and putting the blue striping on it and stuff like that. I put three chandeliers there all next to each other, and then put more of those cheat lights is what I'm gonna call them. And yeah, they just go there and they just hang out and make sure that it's all lit up. I even put some over this archway area into the kitchen and the dining room. Put it over the desk. That desk is from the store and stuff like that. This is a diesel chair. I really like this chair. I wish I had a chair just like this. Not in that color, but you know, I like the design of the chair. And then I like that, oh my gosh, I can't talk. I like that not chandelier, that floor lamp as well. I added a little rug there. And I put that there. And that there. And I changed the color of that, and then I moved the art sculpture up a little bit so it's not right on the table. And then I put flowers and a phone there. And I put a plant thing there. I don't know what I put there though. I don't think I show it, 'cause that's what I put there. And I'm putting drapes in here. Those drapes then get moved down to the floor after a while, 'cause I find that them being able to look under is not the right thing. But them to look over is not the right thing either, but still they can look over if they wanted to. Is that creepy? Putting some drapes in. Making them blue because the dining room's blue, so I thought that the drapes should be blue too. I thought about putting them there as like a decoration, but they didn't really fit, so. Here we go into the living room slash entertainment room and pool table room, I guess. Entertainment room is the word. Here I go putting some of that black on the floor in the half wall type area. Putting the stairs in. I made this living room yellow. I don't know why. I just thought it looked cool. I put the pool table in first, but then I was like, no, I should put everything else in first. I did leave the grand piano out though. Here we go. I put in that TV, this couch. Excuse the background noise. My dad's trying to get everybody to go to bed. Putting lamps in and everything. I make a stage here. I think that was a really good idea. I put a stage in for the piano to sit atop because I think that having the piano raised makes it more important. And I know that the piano in my life is more important because I play piano myself, so, and I'm on it like every single minute of the day. So, and I tried to put some pyrotechnics and some lights that would, you know, decorate, but it didn't work. And so, yeah. And I reposition the piano quite a few times. And then I move it because outside, if you can't see through the window already, the stage is outside now, and I don't want that. I put that little side table right there. I was looking through the lights, see what's there to put there. And I put that, I think. Yeah. I put some more of these lights down and I put some on top to make it light on top so that the color, since that door makes the wall warped, I didn't want the door to, the color to look warped because the top was dark and the bottom was dark. I put a pool table and a guitar and Yeah, and I've made everything almost white and yellow in this room. Or everything white and yellow in this room. I'm putting a desk and a computer, I think I put on it right there. Make everything yellow. I should have made the keypad yellow, but you know, whatever. It doesn't have to be that psychotic yellow. I put that painting at first, and then I change it because I didn't like it. There's another painting I put in there. And I think that it's almost done. This is where I start to think maybe putting the drapes on the bottom would be the best instead of the top. So I put the drapes on the bottom, and that's when I started moving all the drapes in the other rooms to the bottom. So yeah, you see how it like has a little bit of the thing, the glass on the top. Here we go. Upstairs, laying out the floor plan. This is when I started, you know, trying to figure out how I was gonna put the doors and stuff like that. Yeah, that's what I did. I was gonna put a bathroom there, but then that ends up becoming one whole room in just one small hallway. That's the exact size of the hallway that stays. And I have to level it out at the top. And that's another bathroom right there. Here I go making the putting stairs in. Go away! I'm putting carpet in and lights. Trying to make it bright and light up and everything. Here I go making another little, making a little bathroom. This becomes a blue bedroom. I don't know why I made it a blue bedroom. I know I said I put a lot of blue in this house, and I did, but it's called Tropical Blue, so it kind of works. Here's an Island Paradise bed that we just got. And side tables that go with it. And I'm trying to match the dresser color to the bed, but I think it works. I put like a little ottoman at the bottom of the bed to make it, and I made it match color. I put a mirror there from Seasons, which I really like. I really like that mirror. That mirror is really awesome. And a picture right there, and I put lighting. Because there has to be at least like a lamp in there somewhere to make the actual light make sense, or else it doesn't make sense at all. And then I put a giant chandelier in the middle of the room, and since it was on higher level, I could put it anywhere I wanted. So, because even if the Sims go under it, it won't block their path. Here, you can see a little bit of what I meant by textured while it's warped right there. I just ended up changing it to become black. I just made it a black bathroom. I should have just made that one wall black, but I made the entire thing black. And I matched the countertop to the wall. I don't know why I did that either. I think that was a really stupid move. Putting some decorations just to make it look like an actual bathroom. Put in double sinks. Here come, well, I'm putting the colors in for the bedroom. I made it a green bedroom. Here I go, changing that horrible green color. Did I change it to white? I did. I changed it just white. That makes more sense anyway. So there's no more green. Yippee. So, and I changed the middle line right there so that was a different color anyway. So that would tie in the other color, the white color in. Now I'm just adding the colors on the top part right there. You can see how different it looks. You can see how really different it looks. I just noticed something. I don't know if you guys noticed it. I'm not gonna point it out, because I'm gonna go change it. I'm gonna have to go in and look at this house before I download it anyway. I usually do that before I download a house so that I make sure that I got everything in there. This is just a green bedroom. I just thought it would be interesting just to put the green back. So I brought some earth tone green colors, black chrome and stuff. And again, I put the, since it was split leveled, I put the drapes on the bottom so that you would be able to see on the top. I don't know why I didn't put any behind the, oh, I know why. Cause you can't even see through that window anyway. I put a little sitting area here. I love this set. It's called the mid-century set, and the bed doesn't come with it. Just the table and chairs came with it. I'm putting lights in and coloring them. I put a desk in, I think. Yeah, right there. And I put a bookshelf. I wanted to put that bookshelf, but it looked too informal for a really formal room, because it's not, that shelf had like boxes on it from like university life and stuff like that. So it didn't really match the theme. Here we go, putting stuff into the second bathroom. I put pretty much the same thing from that one bathroom. That's what I'm doing. I'm dragging everything over that one bathroom into this bathroom so that I didn't really have to do much. I just had to copy and paste pretty much and reposition everything. There go the lights in the hall. I do the hallway the last as the last thing I do, because I didn't think like I would put anything in the hallway, but I found something I would be able to put in the hallway from watching a fellow simmer, Sim Supply. I saw this couch that I knew I had, but I didn't think of at the moment. I was like, oh, that would go in that one hallway there. I think that would look really good. So I put it in there because I just saw it, I saw it and I was like, ooh, I'm putting that in. So I left that blue wall in there. I think that was a actually really smart idea. Because it's like an accent wall, because all that is a closet. I make it a closet with a window and just an archway. And I was gonna recolor it over, but I was like, nah, it looks cool. So I made it like that. And I'm picking lights to put in. I've been obsessed with those lights. Those lights are from the base game. I don't know why, though. And I put this puzzle piece thing in there because this is supposed to be kind of like a kids room. I'm not very good at decorating kids' rooms, so I just made it that. One thing I did not put in there were any toy chests. So if you were to download it, you would need to put in some toy chests because, yeah, that's not working. That one painting that you saw me put in the hall, that doesn't stay either. Now, this is the yellow bedroom. Yellow and black bedroom, I should say. And I usually use yellow anytime I can, because yellow is a really cool color. It's really bright. I don't know what I was doing there. I took the color from the living room and brought it upstairs and put it as an accent wall, but then I made the other walls like a gray color with like black textures. And I changed these side tables. I tried to make it look industrial, kind of, but not too industrial that wasn't worth living in, you know what I mean? Made the side tables black, put those lamps in, and changed the dresser color there, and put a mirror in. That's pretty much all I put in there, 'cause I didn't know what to put in there, and it's a really small room, and I put a rug. It's a really small room, so I didn't know what to do, so I just kept it like that. I'm looking around like, what can I do? But I couldn't do anything. Now I'm gonna put, I tried to put like lounge chairs, but I didn't do that after all. I ended up putting a table in. Yeah, that table. And I changed the color of the chair to be blue and like a really light blue. I actually like that decision because that gives the Sims free will to go upstairs and read at that area. Because I don't think I put really many chairs for them to read upstairs. Here I am putting some lights around the house. Because you gotta make it light. I put some lights on the roof too. Like they're like pot lights, only they're on the floor. And I put some on there, and then I put some right there and there and there, just to light stuff up. And when I turn out the lights here in a minute, you'll see why. It's really cool. Look. Yeah. So, I don't know what I was doing right there. I was just thinking maybe I should, what I w should do with that part. But here I go landscaping just for a little while because I think I'm coming close to not be ending this part that I had recorded because it was getting really late. I did work on this really late sometimes because, like, I know late isn't like 8 o'clock to probably some of you guys, but 8 o'clock is pretty late for me. As just like being on the computer late, like being up late is not even close to being 1 o'clock. I mean, 8 o'clock. Here, I'm trying to pick something to put in this flower bed right here. I was thinking these banana leaf things, but I put those instead, those ferns. Put banana leaves there though. And I tried to use some of the Island Paradise stuff and put it in there. I put a bunch of palm trees there and stuff. Here I go making the pool area. The pool, I was trying to pick a tile part thing. The pool area is pretty cool. It has a water slide, it has a pool bar, it has a waterfall, it has a whole bunch of things, so your Sims will definitely not become sad in any way when playing at this really awesome pool place. I made it square because I couldn't get the curved pool to work, so I was like, ugh, I'm just gonna make it square. Trying to match the pool bottom with the pool bar. And putting in like a little tiled thing at the bottom, and there's the shark slide and the waterfall and the diving board. And I corner on the corner of the things there, I make it like not a corner but a straight edge. I put a little atrium type area here for the hot tub. I put really cool skylight stuff here. They're like big glass like glass triangles, I guess you can say. I changed the wall color so I can put the pillars there and it wouldn't look weird. I changed the way that the skylights were positioned. I make a little grilling area over here from Outdoor Living Stuff Pack stuff. They have like counters that are outside and a really nice grill and a fridge and a sink. I tried to use outside the Outdoor Living Stuff Pack there, and then I put a bar there from Late Night. Now I'm gonna start putting in dirt around, because these are also flower beds right here. Right there, it kept saying that I was underneath the house when I really wasn't. So, and I'm putting this border around. I put a pathway from the gazebo to the back. I thought that was really cool because when you walk up to the house and you see the gazebo, you can go up into the gazebo and then you can turn and come right out so that you can go right to the back, which I thought was really awesome. Changing the color of the deck to a darker shade. I'm extending this flower bed right here a little bit. And then I notice, oh my gosh, I have a door there. Here I go putting in some dirt. And I'm filling that in there so that when I do fill that dirt in, it doesn't get on the painting that I already did. That's when I noticed that I had that door there. Oh, no, it isn't. Oh. That's when I this must have been, like, right where I noticed, because, right there. That's when I noticed that there was a door there. Because I had forgotten about it, so. tried filling it in as best as I could, and I did awesome. I put some more of these ferns in, and some of these ficus, I think. I don't know what they are. I call them porcupine bushes, I guess. I think the house is pretty much done. It's just the outside landscaping that needs done. Like, once I was done the inside of the house, I was like, yes, I'm almost done. So, you know, I was, like, jumping for joy. I tried to put a little bit of color right there, but I didn't like it after a while. And I tried to put that there, but I didn't like it. Put more of those there. This is really cool because you see how I landscape and... Well, I think this whole house building video is so cool because you can see how I build the house and how I landscape the house and, you know, what I do first and what I do second. And everything here is in order, like all of the video is in order from each day that I did this. So you can see, like, what I did do and how I did it. And I kept the bar at the bottom of the screen to be in the shot because I thought, well, some of you guys don't know what Sims 3 is, and I wanted to show you what it would look like when you build. I just wanted to tell you guys for right now, 344,000 and counting, 345,000 and counting is what this house is cost. So it's a luxury house. It's really nice. It's really expensive. If you really want to live in it, you would use the money motherlode cheap. But I like to, well, sometimes I like to, you know, wait and just earn the money myself. So I kind of narrowed some of the stuff that I had down. I wanted palm trees and tropical stuff, so I got. So I took Showtime, Island Paradise, and some of the store content and put it in the box down there. Because you can sort through those like that. And I put them down there so that when I do want something tropical, I can just go in and click it. I'm putting some flowers, I guess they're called. I don't know what they are. Here I put the trees, and I'm almost done, actually, I think. Put those in. Yeah, I'm almost done, literally. I put some fountains over there. Now, I was thinking about putting one right there, but I didn't. Now I'm going to go around and put some dirt underneath the trees in around the edge of the house. Because it just to make it look actually real and natural, and that the house just wasn't just put there. It was, you know, it was made with the ground. I put a plant right there. Took forever for that thing to load. Oh, I am running this 5 times the speed I built it. Just to let you know, because it is, so that took a ton of time. Just think about that, 5 times the actual speed. And there's that white sofa I was talking about earlier, about Sims Supply showing me, and then I put my favorite painting there. I really love that painting's so cool. And then I think... Oh, I was trying to figure out a painting to put there. And I put a carpet here, a rug. I tried to make it blue and white, but for some reason it wasn't coming out the way I wanted it to. But I got it the way I wanted it after everything. And then I told you that was going bye-bye. Here's a little... study nook, I guess you could say. This is like, it's like a desk with a laptop and 2 bookshelves. I was thinking about putting just a regular computer, but there's no other laptop in the house, so I put a laptop, a dark blue laptop, and I changed the chair color a little. And I put that painting, well, it's not a painting, that photo there. And I got, I made this outside area. But we're coming down to the end of the video. I want to say thank you guys for watching so much or listening. It really means a lot to me, especially since this is a very long video. So yeah, I'm trying to end this right when it needs to. Photos are going to be at the end. I'm Robert Simmer, and I will see you guys later. Bye.
Bye.